trying to send a guy from Pittsburgh who lives by my post office, and this is doing an issue with video. I thank the bus lady, she let me go bus. So I can get to the three if I'm lucky and go direct to Walmart and get my kitty food. And I want to thank Lisa M, the pet food coupon lady, for subscribing to my channel. Thank you for subscribing. Push the button to be notified of new videos like this one. And just standing out there for about 10 minutes, I am frozen. So I'm so glad to be on the bus. That's the county treasurer's office. And this used to be the Martinez Museum. I'm not sure what it is over here. And now we head down by the railroad tracks to the old Amtrak station. If I don't make this too long, because I'll run out of time and I'll edit. So have a great day, great afternoon, a great evening. Stay warm and safe out there. And this is George Center, the guy from Pittsburgh. Enjoy the rest of the day. My mouth is very dry and water. Enjoy the rest of the video. Bye-bye for you. This is George Sinden. I forgot I can't continue with the other app, so I'm just using the camera, so this is a recycling set. And it never fails to amaze me. I'll come in, I'm the only one here. The minute I come up, there's 18 guys show up in their cars. So, a bunch of stuff. I don't know what it is, but it's just duly a place. They don't take metal, so I don't know who takes metal. The guy got pissed off a few minutes ago and did a donut in his truck and got mad and made dust and made a mess. So, alright, here's my cord of bottles and cans. So whatever I get, plus the $2 to change, I got a dollar on the change. The cops come off here, I'll go for coffee now. All right, I'll be back in a few minutes to tell you about why first you live and why. Bye-bye for now. Okay, this is me again, people, and I got a big one that I expected. I wish I could carry the rest of it. It's not quite enough. So I'll get this $14.25. And, a box of 32 cans of Friskies runs about $17, so I'm a little short, folks. I got a dollar left in the bank. So, I'm going to head to Walmart now and get the kitty food, so at least they can get fed. And I hope the lady at First Premier Bank said the card should arrive by Friday. So I think I can feed them till Friday. I called my friend to say, help! He might have 20 bucks in the bank for me, and nobody of my subscribers or listeners or viewers has donated any cat food or cat food money. So this is what I'm going to do, a quick pan of this. This is what it looks like back here. And I will walk to the front. And First Premier Bank screwed me because they told me when I called them last week, they sent a letter on the 7th that arrived last week. Your application is being processed. And I said, oh, great. So I called them up. I said, I got this letter today, or yesterday, actually. It was day the 7th. When do you send the card out? They said, the 8th. I said, great. When should I get it? Around Valentine's Day. All right, I'll take Kathy. I'll take Fuzzy to the vet. Buy my cat food. Buy food for me. Things will be great. I went through four different operators today, including a guy who kept trying to get me to pay on my other card. And I said, look, I pay my card on the first of the month, like all my other bills. And he kept trying and trying. And I finally said, what don't you understand? I know. So I got to the fourth operator. I said, look, I only want to ask one question to get a simple answer. Have you mailed the new card or not? And finally, after hemming and hawing, he told me, yeah, they mailed it on Valentine's Day. Thank you. So, yeah, I should have it by Friday. Luckily, my Meals and Real stuff comes Wednesday, and I'll be eating toast for school. And I have four hot dogs left, but I did get some fruit and vegetables. I'll show you that when I get home. And I gotta wait for the bus forever. walk up to Walmart, wait for the three, and take that home. So I have at least something to eat for tomorrow night, vegetables if nothing else, and the bread with peanut butter. And here's a part of Martinez Creek. No creatures in it, lots of algae. Go around the corner and show you the formerly abandoned Mr. T's. And Mr. T was a really nice guy. He fed kitties, cat used to live around the corner. And then he died, another guy took it over, he jacked the prices up. And Mr. T was alive, all of the frame workers ate at his restaurant. And when the new guy took over, they wouldn't pay the outrageous prices and they stopped going and the place closed up. So this is coming up is, I've never eaten there. Kathy's eaten here, said it's okay. They're only open for lunch and breakfast. It's TJ's Cafe. They've been here for years. This is the 3210 Pacheco. And so it's automotive parts store. I don't know anywhere. There's a big truck bed place down at Ace Hardware down the street. And I didn't notice they deliver food. I'll have to look at their menus. Now these guys are open 7 days a week, which is surprising because there's nobody out here on Saturday and Sunday, I guess, except oil work. Cheap breakfast and lunch here. $4.99 for breakfast, $5.99 for lunch special. Now they say do not eat the lunch special. Oh, they are open. But no, they're not open. One sign says closed. The other one says open. Who knows? And then we'll take it. Another moron driving around. I don't think they're open. Let's see. No, they have bananas, but they're not open. Okay. So I'll have to come up here in the bus and lot of time to wait for the next bus to go back and see what the food is like and the coffee. Anyway, this is Pacheco and Howe Road. And this goes up to the county housing office, and up the street is Walmart and Nestle's water company is there. Humble Water Company is there. Never had Nestle's water. And this was Mr. T's restaurant. It had a big Mr. T's here for years, but it looks like they finally took the Mr. T's down and they're doing something here. So this has been closed for years and years and years. Bored of that. Never thought Emmy would do anything with it. But all the restaurant signage is gone. And look inside. Now they took all the restaurant stuff out of here too. There's some blueprints there. So they're doing something here. I don't know what. But Kathy said he fed about 12 cats here. Every day they showed up for food. Oh, the Lunchbox Sandwich Shop is coming soon. There's Build Tech, Concrete Supplies, and over where that first car is, that's where we buried a little cat. She ran out in the street and got killed by a truck, and Kathy used to live on that street. All right, I'm going to head over to the bus stop before I wind up missing the bus. I have no idea when it comes, and there's a little bus schedule from the bus, and I didn't think to bring one. I'm not used to having a new backpack, so I got to get prepared, but at least getting rid of these cans and bottles frees up space in my hallway to do the laundry and put it in bins. All right, this is George Sendler, the guy from Pittsburgh. Have a great day and stay warm and safe out there. It is definitely nippy and my mouth is very dry. And there you can see Howe Road. I've walked up that and down. It's a long walk. And here is the front of the part of the Shell refinery. And so that's where your gasoline comes from. And I'm sure they have other refineries in California. But this has been here since 1915. And cat, mouse, baby mouse used to go in this area here when it was a field and would catch lizards. I miss my baby mouse cat. He disappeared one day. I think someone killed him. All right, that's it for now. I'm gonna head over here to the bus stop, wait to take the bus, and walk the 2 blocks to Walmart. Okay. There's that goes to Concord, and on the other side of that hill is the freeway that sits in the airfield of the Vallejo or Benicia, and the bridges, of course. I wish banks would tell the truth, although I'm expecting too much honest behavior from a financial institution. I don't think there is such a thing. Maybe the Army, maybe credit, they have a pretty good reputation. All right, bye-bye for now. Well, this is George Sunday sitting in the room waiting for the bus to go home, and I forgot one very important thing. I went to Walmart to go around looking for one item. I froze last night in my apartment. I had to turn on all 3 electric heaters. My bills would go through the roof this month. But I just couldn't get warm again. I didn't sleep all Monday. It was so cold. It was 30 at 4:30 when I woke up and did a video. It was 29 at 5:30. So I go around to Walmart, I look in the bedding department, and I can't find any anywhere. I'm looking for a heated throw and an electric blanket to buy when I get the credit card. Well, what happens, I go to CSM, which is a manager, would be an assistant manager anywhere else, and she says, they're out of season, we don't sell them anymore, they're ordering bathing suits. Now, last I looked, it's still winter in February, the last thing on my list of the top 100 things that pop my mind when it's 29 degrees is bathing suits. This has got to be the stupidest marketing thing I have ever heard of. Bathing suits in February. All right, enjoy the rest of the video. This is George Sunday, the guy from Pittsburgh. I am shaking my head in disbelief. Incredibly stupid things they do with corporate decisions, and that's got to be on my top 5 dumb things I've ever heard of. This is not the dumbest. No electric blankets in February because it's not Christmas time, I guess. Something, I don't know. And maybe they'll start selling in the 4th of July. Who knows? All right, bye-bye for now. Hello, well, I'm here at Walmart. I got 24 cans of the cat concoctions, which the kitties love. I bought a can of soda for me. And 5 cans of the Fancy Feast with cheddar for my kitties. And to add to my hot dogs tonight, for me, a can of beef tamales. That'll be dinner. And I'll share the vegetables when I come home. This was all of $16.99. Tomorrow I'll take it if I'm up to it. I'm freezing. I stood up waiting for the bus for about 20 minutes and still frozen. And I'll take the rest of the cans and bottles and get more kitty food. All right, this is George Sender, the guy from Pittsburgh. I'm headed for the bus and home. And kitty food, and then I go home and try to get warm again. Bye-bye for now. Have a great night and stay warm and safe out of here. Stay warm and safe out there if you can. Bye-bye.